go for the meeting, did you guys get my update on ice rink that failed? Or didn't?
About the liner?
Yes.
So was that, and my question to you was that the new liner or was that the?
It is the new liner.
So that only lasts a year, is that?
I don't know how it was stored or what, but I'm assuming it's on, you don't know, I don't know. I don't know anything about liners.
The liner was lost for last season, you mean, is it, or did somebody just buy it?
It was the one that Tia bought last year prior to the cycle, so yeah.
So did they, so they used it all last year?
Yes. And then they stored it behind the fire station.
Think that it would last for $1,000 or whatever it would last more than.
What was the problem, was it ripped or?
It's ripped and cracked.
It's just like cracked and then all over, it's pretty damaged. We won't be able to use it.
So.
Do we need a liner to use it? I don't know anything about ice rinks either.
I think so, just because water's just gonna go right into the ground.
Okay.
And it makes your ice bumpy too, it's not so smooth.
So she's looking for other options and wanna keep us in the loop.
So they're working on that, so they were more than, they were eager to take it over and so.
Great, have fun.
Here's the chief's number.
You weren't at the last select board meeting, but they asked, they were gonna reach out to her and ask her to come into the select board and talk to her about some of the disclaimers that are up there, so that if she's running it, she knows what she's responsible for doing it. She's not responsible for being there and recognizing somebody's there or something.
She didn't send me an email about that.
Suzanne said something about it.
She'll let me know.
Well, do we have an agenda?
Not really, no. I know what you wanted to talk about in closed session.
Yes.
Whatever you guys talked about last meeting, if there's anything coming from that you wanted to follow up on. Otherwise, I have a couple of topics.
Yeah, I have a couple of topics too. So I guess I reached out, so Dee and I had talked way back now, you probably didn't even know, I'll tell you, about a fundraiser. A possible fundraiser that we could share with the PTO. And I reached out to Jody, because I know she's not the president, but I couldn't at the time remember who was, so I knew she was a part of it. So I was like, I reached out to her and asked her what they would think. So Dee and I had talked about these calendars. And I don't know, have all of you guys bought or done these before?
Like baseball calendars?
They're pretty awesome. And the initial effort is to find gift card donations for every day of the month.
Mm-hmm.
But what you do is you have every kid sell 10 of these for $10 a piece. And you give out all this stuff, you have a drawing every single day. And you can kind of look over, a lot of them are local businesses donate $25 to this, and or Dustin's to $25. The Black Bean always seems to give out, so there's different things in there. They usually have a kind of a big prize for like the last day or whatever. But you know, if we do that through RGS, and we can really promote like everybody sell 10, I mean, that could be a potential $10,000 income bringing in. So I said something to the PTO, like, we could split that with you if you guys are on board with it. And it's not a lot of hard work, you know, it's not. So
each kid who would be going to camp.
Well, that's a thought. So the thought here could be, and different places do it different ways, right? So I've been on softball programs that whatever you raise goes back to you directly. So we could use that as incentive. Or we could just be like, here's a fundraiser. This is going towards, you know, half summer rec, half PTO.
Is that something the PTO would be willing to spearhead for us?
Well, that's when I reached out, and I'm surprised that Jody hasn't gotten back to me. But maybe she's talking to the president. Who's the president of the PTO?
Shayna.
Okay.
And they actually, I tried to go, and I, in January, and I drove by the school the first two Tuesday nights, because it's supposed to be Tuesday nights. And there was like two cars there, so I didn't think it was anybody.
Yeah.
And then I asked one of Catherine's classmates, parents, who is all the people too, and she said they, two of them showed up for their meeting, so they didn't discuss anything or do any new business.
Okay. So they meet once a week.
Once a month. You know, what would be really great is if we could do it in the spring.
Like March. I was thinking March, because it's 31 days.
March would be good. That, I mean, I have a list of all the people we reached out to last year.
Yeah.
For donations, and some of them, some of the pizza places and stuff, do give like $25 gift cards, $50 gift cards, and I've actually been reaching out to them again to make sure that they have the tax information that they need for last year.
Do we have? Do you recall if we had a sponsorship letter from last year? Like a donation number with a tax ID on it?
It did not have the tax ID number on it. The tax ID number got added to one or two of them when the companies asked, like Walmart requested that ahead of time, Target did. But the rest of them were like, just get it to us. So a bunch of the letters have already gone out. I have a couple more that I have to drop in the mail.
So I don't know, I was just kind of thinking, I don't know if we want to go into this fundraising thing.
I think we should. Because I worry, you know, CNJ, they were sponsored last year.
And you think they're going to come back?
Well, see, that's my concern is if they don't. I mean, having some fundraising dollars that were towards the t-shirts, whatever we may need this year, this would be great. I think we should contact CNJ and see if they're willing to come back. That would be a relief, I think, for many of us.
Yeah.
To know whether or not we have to find that money elsewhere.
Yeah. Was that my contact?
Yeah. But I've been in contact with her recently.
Oh, good. And while I'm thinking about it, was Dick's Sporting Goods ever contacted last year?
I started an application for them.
You did.
However, I was never able to complete it. They were asking some questions that I couldn't answer, and they need a mission statement. So along that lines, I did bring the copy of all three mission statements.
Did you find that?
It was in my email. Yeah. So we can choose one tonight.
I think it was. So Jody, you and Jody looked at it, right, the last time I sent it around?
Maybe. Yeah, but I told you I didn't remember that, but...
Yeah, let me see that one. I'll show you. I think it was...
The reason I asked about Dick's is because... So I just signed up my boys for lacrosse. Lacrosse has an awesome website for registration and payment and they're linked to, so when you sign up for lacrosse, you have to be signed up also with U.S. lacrosse. And if you, so in order, so they send you to that first, and then it says, once you do this, do you want to go back to Marshwood lacrosse and finish? So I reached out to the woman who sent that out, and I said, who do you do your registration system through? And so she said, they get their registration through U.S. Lacrosse, but she believes they pay $350 a year for it.
U.S. Lacrosse does, or
I think Marshwood pays them $350.
Yeah, my son's hockey program has a similar situation with USA Hockey.
Right.
All the hockey programs all have like a similar looking website. And
right.
It's all kind of linked that way. It's great.
So when you signed up to USA...
I'm just thinking about our registration and just making things
streamlining.
As simple as we
that
can.
That should be a major focus this year, is trying to make things easier for everyone.
Which is true. I mean,
we
sat with Caroline. Yeah.
You can't pay online. There's no, because it's
town function, you can't. They can register online and mail a check to the town, but there's no way to pay by credit card.
Right.
You can't register your car by credit
card. Which is what happened the last time we talked to her. They were pretty sure they weren't.
Right, and that's, I mean, just seems like that, just seems.
I just think that if we can't.
Put that on.
Right, and I totally agree. I just think if we can't provide the payment enhancement function of it, we should at least try and provide online registration function for sending in a check. And then we just have to make sure we sync it up with the actual online registration. So we can at least provide some of that. I mean, yeah, online registration with money is, would be so much easier.
Are there any free software out there that would enable us to, I mean, like, you know, Survey Monkey, but to do like a registration or something?
Well, you can actually do something like that through Gmail, Google Docs. You can actually build your own. So you can build surveys that are free. It's just taking the time.
Which could be like a registration type.
Yeah, and it really doesn't need to be anything fancy, as long, you know, soon as we decide.
Just to cut back on paperwork.
Well, you can even do like Sports Illustrated and softball, those Sports Illustrated. And you can get all the information there, but send payment to the set.
Right.
What about the one that Sportco does? Do you remember what they use? I don't know if it's a paid software.
Yeah, I don't know.
That we can.
Just seems like everybody.
Because last year it was all paper, bringing it here, and it seemed like it was going all these different.
And it's just, but it's making tons of copies of things. I mean, that's, just seems like.
Doing other things.
Yeah. But she did, so in, when I asked her about the registration system, what she also said was, there's something about their insurance was involved, so I don't know if that, but she said, if you haven't approached Dick's for sponsorship of any of your programs, I highly recommend it. They give us cash, gift certificates for equipment, and discounts. I know that there are similar websites out there, but I don't know about the cost. So she was just.
So when I went last year, Dick's had two programs that you could apply for. One that was a donation, which was a small amount, and they would. A smaller amount. I think it was, I'm thinking 5,000 or less, or 500 or less. Started with 5. And then they had another one that was larger.
They're different.
Yes, I can look into it again. There was a larger one, which included, they called it their sponsorship program, which included sporting equipment and donations for a larger amount. And you filled out the form, and you could request either sporting goods or cash donations through their sponsorship program. But you have to be specific into what sports you're looking into getting things for. So last year, the assistant director said, it would be great if we had soccer nets, then we could play a game of soccer. So I was like, maybe I'll reach out to Dick's and see if they'll give us soccer nets and balls.
What about Philbrook's? Do you think up around the corner? Do you think they would do some sort of sponsorship?
Who did it hockey? Hockey on the rush.
Pure
they do a
hockey.
Lot of bikes now.
They do bikes, right?
Yeah,
they
kind of
switch
do,
their focus
they do
right
bikes
now.
And then the hockey is with Pure Hockey, which is a big national.
I know they don't do no baseball or softball.
No.
Plus,
well,
Dick's being like a big national.
Right. I think Dick's would have more.
Even for softball, you can easily get a $100 donation. That's a quick one.
From Dick's.
But I was wondering if we go for the big, you know, if you go for the big money, you can buy anything that you want, right? But then we have to count that as monies.
And
for budget.
There was another big one last year. People's Bank now has an office in Dover, and they will give out money up to $15,000. If you go for the $15,000 one, I think it's every 3 years you can apply, but and they give out a $5,000 one every year.
Who's that through?
People's Bank.
Wow.
Optima is new now, so I wondered if they might be itching to get into the community. Some community involvement too, so.
But I know for People's, that's why I started the mission statement, because we need a mission statement for them.
Yep.
And they usually, people's bank picks every year a different segment of the population in which they're going to fund more regularly, or for some of their bigger grants. Like, 1 year it was immigrant communities, 1 year it was the elderly,
mm-hmm.
1 year it was intercities. But they have given in Massachusetts, their Massachusetts-based bank, have given to different cities and towns in Massachusetts. So, I think that possibly
Dan did one.
We all kind of did one.
Yeah.
I just sort of like threw one in. Because I thought
just condensed.
Like what we, yeah, did, we did a short and sweet, small.
Yeah.
But, you know, I'm kind of thinking on big. So I've been getting a magazine because I signed up with something, Recreation Management. And so this is like the buyer's guide. And I've been all over our shade system. So there's like a ton of companies that do these. And I don't know if we need it. I looked on a couple websites the other day, and nobody's listed prices. So that's a problem. So then you have to go and, but you know, my thinking, okay, do we need a custom made shade, or we just need to go get a humongous canopy from Dick's? You know, we got an anonymous donation for two canopies that are I believe 20x40. They're sitting in my garage waiting.
The canopies are. So
yes.
The canopies came in.
Yeah.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
All right, then I can put that away. We can have, we can look in this for
right, so
new play structures and pools.
So
what about safety concerns with the canopies? Can they stay up
yep.
all summer long?
Yeah, we'll put them in view of the, they're on just to be used for rec, and they will be, we can place them in view of the cameras, because there's cameras in front and back, just not on the side of the building. So if we put them over like towards the soccer field area, they're on camera 24/7. And we'll put a nice little sign saying, "Smile, you're on camera." Because the ones that were up last year, they never flashed. So.
Oh, that's fantastic.
So I think, just want to throw this out there, that I think we've talked about 5 or 6 different subjects.
Yeah.
We really have concluded on one of them. So can we take a step back and maybe just work on one? And then let's just maybe do some conclusions. Like, I think the first one was the fundraising calendar. So you said you contacted the PTO.
And I have not heard from them yet.
And
so,
I think it's a great idea.
I think what we need is kind of all of us to be on board with that. If we want to pursue it as a joint venture with PTO, are there any negatives that anybody can think about here?
I just have to go through the, let me throw up an idea.
Yeah, go ahead.
Doesn't this have to go through the SAU? Because if a kid's handing it out at school, it's going to have to go through the SAU. And then they
don't know how
want
PTO,
to share with the town.
I don't know how PTO does it,
yeah.
So I guess that. How do they do their fundraisers? They do a lot of fundraisers.
Yeah, but anything you hand out at school, even for softball or baseball,
yeah.
It has to go through SAU.
Yeah.
Well,
so would we just need clearance through them?
So
that's why I kind of would
yeah.
rather go
like
through
it,
the PTA,
yeah.
PTO, because then they have kind of
the
inside scoop.
Yeah. Yeah, we can help them get the gift certificates if they're willing to hand out
right.
and do the legwork to get it out to the kids.
And it's going to be one of those things where if the kid isn't able to sell all their 10, then the parent has to come up with the money.
Well, I think what we need to decide is what do we want to do? Do we want to, you know, if we, I think now that we've sort of talked about it, I don't think we can have kids sell it per se towards their rec. So I don't know how we're going to.
It would just be a fundraiser for
right.
Rec.
It's
maybe
a fundraiser
right.
for the school.
School,
to
PTO, and to be, right.
Yeah.
Because I think, as I'm thinking about more, like there's going to be kids who are going to sell some of these who don't sign up for rec, right? So what do we do with that money, per se? So
and there's going to be kids who are going to sell them up.
Right.
But I guess my question is, because I've been involved in a situation where, you know, you
would be between us, the committee, and hopefully the kid. Yeah, I don't know how that works. So you contacted Shane?
I did Jody. I sent Jody a text, but I haven't heard anything back from her. So I guess.
So do you want to take a lead on this one, or do you want to take it to another, like, splitting up into subgroups and somebody has a fundraising and somebody doesn't?
Yeah, I don't want to lead on anything.
I'm concerned that if we.
And I'll tell you why in 1 minute.
If we share, we're not going to get it possibly as much money as we hope. And then that cuts into our donors that we're asking for money from, like, or our other donors.
Oh,
like,
I see what you're saying.
Like, I can't go to Weetsie's Pizza and ask them
twice
for gift cards. And they gave us $50 worth of gift cards last year for the calendar, and then go back to them in 3 months and ask for a cash donation or something. And I know the guy at Weetsie's Pizza is more than willing to help us because he's a Rollinsford resident.
Right.
So, or I don't want to go to some of these same companies twice in a row.
Right.
I know that's
a good point.
I know McDonald's used to do a thing on Tuesdays where, as long as you had people inside cleaning up the tables, whatever was sold between 5 and 8, you got a profit of that. The softball league made $250 every time we did it.
Hmm.
So for 3 hours of cleaning tables, and you didn't need much staff. You just needed 2 or 3 parents to do it. Like, it was a real, out of all the fundraisers we ever do, that one was my favorite because it was the easiest.
And you said McDonald's?
Yeah. So
I just know, like, on these, like, I just seems like my family always buys them because it's like $10, I'll buy it. And you know, you have a chance. Some of these they give 2 things away. Like, everybody wins, like, all the time. You know, so it's kind of, yeah. I certainly don't want parents to feel like they need to throw in their $100 or whatever. You know.
Well, some of the fundraisers we did last year too was the food, right? It was pizza and coffee.
Mm-hmm. And actually, that was something I was going to bring up, is that I went to the school meeting, the school budget meeting, on January 11th, or whatever, a couple weeks ago, and there was nobody, there was a small group of people there, but there was nobody selling coffee and donuts, and one of the other parents said to me, you know, it would be nice if somebody could come in and sell coffee and donuts and bring people and have that. Now, their meeting, the school is having their big meeting of everything on the agenda February 3rd, which is 2 weeks away.
Good to know.
It's all right together.
So, I don't know. The person I was talking to said they would reach out to the PTO. And I don't know if they have or not. It was the school district meeting. So they're going to review everything on the ballot to the school.
Ooh. And ours is on the 10th,
right? Which is the following Saturday.
So
budget committee, that's the budget committee.
That's
the 10th.
Yeah. Town budget. Everything else but the school. So we could sell that.
I'll sit at that table.
Sorry, you have another table reserved for you.
I'll sit at the coffee table. So,
do we know what time that is?
I think it's 9.
Okay.
And childcare is supposed to be provided. One of the school board members informed me that they are trying to get childcare for the school meeting. I don't know.
Does the PTO normally do something? Is that why you mentioned the PTO?
Well, somebody said, well, the other parents said they were going to reach out to the PTO.
Mm-hmm.
But, like I said, nobody went to the last PTO meeting, so I don't know if they reached out to them by email or something. And the PTO did in years past. I know they have, but, like, even last year, they weren't at town meeting. The PTO wasn't. It was the library, the historical committee, and the work committee.
Yeah.
And we made quite a bit of money, and we sold out of pizzas when we bought pizzas for the town meeting.
And you also have.
Yeah, we did a town
for that. Yeah, well, it won't be as long this year. Last year went super long because of the warrant articles for the bond. I'm hoping it won't be as long this year. But
We also have voting day that Tuesday as well. So remember we had a bucket up there.
Mm-hmm.
And we made like, I don't know, $150 or something.
Mm-hmm.
Just by people dropping in a buck or two.
Now what day is that?
Tuesday the 13th.
Of February?
March.
March.
Okay, that's what I thought. I thought we were in March for these things. So I was like...
So
yes.
We've got three potential opportunities.
Four, if you have voting day.
And then
mm-hmm.
four.
So you have Tuesday
so
is voting day on your ballot, and then you have your town meeting day on the 17th of March.
So what is the Tuesday deal?
Yeah.
The 13th.
Piggyback for that. So
the morning,
mm-hmm. 13. And what was the other one after that? 17th?
The 17th.
Okay.
When you get reappointed.
Reappointed.
So we could use all of these days to ask if we can set up a table.
Yes.
And do coffee and donuts or something.
Mm-hmm.
And just have a donation bin.
Yep. I think so. I think that's a great idea. I mean, we're not going to have any cafeterias or anything like that, but we can.
Well,
we
can
have our signs and we'll have things like that. We have a Camp Raleigh T-shirt, the public ones.
Yeah. I sell community ones of those.
Are we going to do that again this year?
Do
you think, or
don't know?
Can we sell the extra ones that I have at my house?
Absolutely.
How many do you have?
Yeah,
15.
Really?
Let's
sell them.
Yeah.
The 17th is, what was the 17th?
Town meeting day at the school.
That's St. Patrick's Day.
You
know where I'm going to be.
Oh, God. My mother's birthday is that Friday. I was going out of town that day.
It's always the second Tuesday of the month.
Okay,
and
so
then that's
four potentials. So we're going to do coffee.
I'm coming back from a scrapbooking meeting. So.
Donuts.
On the 3rd
is the school. Yes, the school. We call it the school district. Mm-hmm.
So,
deliberatives. All right. Well, let's go with D's flow on, okay.
So,
back to this. Do we want to just talk to PTO and think, and we'll...
I still think we should look into it and see what they have to say.
Yeah,
they
want
to
do the school leg of it.
Well,
I mean, so I've done these for softball that you have to sell 10, which I hate to say that, but I think if we can, I'd rather not use those words, but if you, I mean, we have 100, how many kids? 120 kids?
If
you get
PTO, how much will it
like 50-50, I think, right? I mean, if we can... You know, hunt down as many kind of gift cards as they can, and if they're willing to do that, yeah. I mean, you could potentially really, if we have like a prize for the most calendars sold, that's kind of,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Do you know?
Good incentive.
In the cash box, I had given them like $25 gift cards to Rogers. To Rogers Pizza in Dover. If they ever got used.
I don't know.
Where is the cash
did
box?
Did we ever give it back?
I don't know.
So Caroline
is
okay.
Because there might be $25 in gift cards there.
We can put those right
in
the
account.
I thought
they
something for the emergency days.
I think James came home and told me one day that the directors had ordered pizza for their staff. Because he was like, where did you get this pizza? And I'm thinking, how did you get that? Then I realized it was.
Yeah, I remember there was pizza for all of them one day or something.
Mm-hmm.
An end of season kind of thing.
Yeah, so can you use it for that?
Yeah.
So we can just assume we're starting from scratch. We don't have any leftover. Okay, so back to the PTO. You don't
so
want
I,
to.
I reached out to Jody. So maybe once Jody contacts me, we can go from there.
Okay, so what you can do if you want is get the information and bring it back to us. And
yes.
If you don't want to spearhead somebody, maybe else can.
Okay.
We'll start breaking off into little groups. And
my question
is who's going
to
do
it? Would it be more beneficial for us to drum up the gift cards now and then have the Raleigh camp kids
take them home with them over like the first couple weeks of summer and do it in the month of August, that also has 31 days.
Mm-hmm.
And then have it back by July 15th, and then we could have extra money.
No, I don't like the idea of kids coming to camp and having to sell something.
Yeah.
I don't like that idea at all.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's,
and you're lucky I show up with them dressed by summertime.
Yeah, and this way it kind of gets all the kids in the school. I mean, we can also, too, use that as a sort of a promotion, right? Like,
mm-hmm.
summer rec,
mm-hmm.
you know, and start put. And actually, I have to tell you, somebody already sent me an email. When can we start signing up for summer rec?
As soon as you figure out a tuition program.
Right, so that, so people are thinking about it.
Yeah,
yeah.
That's good.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
You can start doing little teasers on Facebook.
I told her at the beginning of March. I was like, I think March. March is a good month.
Do you want me to start putting up things again?
Little teasers?
Yeah. You can if you want.
I've been trying, like,
thanks, summer.
Come up, like, softball and baseball signups, and then putting those on,
mm-hmm.
and, you know, practices and things like that. But
yeah, I don't see why not.
Anything that has to do with sports, I can put it up.
So, are we finished up with the calendar?
I think so.
Yeah, she's
going
to
take the, I'll hear what PTO, if, you know, positive, negative, nothing, then we can go from there in our next gathering.
Okay. And I will spearhead the four opportunities we have for fundraising. I'm calling the first one, you know, make contact with the school or the school board. And then the other three are town functions, I believe.
Right? Well, they're all, three of them are at school, so.
They're all at the school, but.
The only one that's here is Tuesday, so.
Yeah.
And I'll mention it tomorrow about putting up a table again. Because we had a table out in the hallway.
Yeah.
For that. So.
Yes, that would look good.
Good.
Yes.
Bring that back.
You said you have
15
shirts.
Yep. There you go. I'll go through my next. So, basketball. So let me tell you.
So,
yes.
We're all done with shade coverings.
Yeah.
We're all done with the fundraising for now. The ice rink we've talked about. He wanted us to finish up what we have already started.
Do we
mission
start?
State.
The mission state.
The mission state.
So I was just looking at it to make sure that I encompass something about activities, and I just realized it does. So
what? So
it,
what
it
was the last
too,
thing?
I think it was Cecilia's point for trying to get sponsorships. It's good to have something in there about activities and experiences or things that we're trying to create for the community.
Yeah,
and
sponsorships.
That's just my thought, but I don't know.
And some people, like People's Bank and stuff like that, will look for, ask for, and Dix might ask for your mission statement. So,
okay.
I kind of like this too in here. So I like what he has right here. I like the beginning of that. This one, I mean, that one's good, but I wonder if we can just sort of
the first sentence here with the second sentence there.
And maybe, so like this, so if we went like this, and then take this one out, and maybe start there, so here to here.
Well, that's the English guy. To provide fun, positive, and rewarding recreational opportunities for the residents of Rollinsford and surrounding communities. We'll offer a wide range of engaging activities and experiences for all ages while providing safe and well-maintained parks and public places.
Yeah, the only issue is
a conjunction.
I mean,
pink.
No, I don't. The first one is like, you know, not a complete sentence.
Yeah.
Know.
So I'll tell you what. What
are
you
all right.
Intro.
Or you could just write it in that intro.
Yeah.
You make it two sentences.
Yeah, two
you're
sentences.
Our wordsmith.
And if we can vote on a mission statement, then we can put it on our website and we can have it available for all of our programs and donations.
Yeah, Joey, you can post it.
But let Dan edit it before I post it. We found that out. Dan has access. He can post.
That's right.
Yeah, I guess so. I guess so. Access.
And we should probably vote on mission statement.
I just think that mission statements are usually one sentence.
They're really short.
Yeah, I don't know.
I mean, there's a slogan.
So can you condense?
There's a mission statement. I think a mission statement is meant to be no more than two sentences.
I really think it's supposed to be. I remember looking at a list of popular ones, and they were all really pretty short. Yeah.
Well, you know, we've got two sentences there.
Right.
You just pick whatever one you like.
We keep it. I mean, it's fine.
Cut out a couple of adjectives.
Yeah, if you can condense it. Condense the idea. Because I like what you had on the first line. I really like that. I guess what we need to do is just make sure that, you know, again, if we think about people who are looking at the mission statement and wanting to sponsor us, are we giving a clear message of what we do?
Like, doesn't fun, positive, rewarding recreational opportunities kind of include sort of activities and experiences? Like
so
recreational opportunities? Mm-hmm. I'm just saying we need recreational opportunities and
Or maybe we just go back to what you originally had and keep it at that.
Just the first one. I mean, because I don't think the second one is adding that much other than the safe and well-maintained parks and public places.
Not adding any value to the first one?
I think that...
question was, do you need additional help at behind the tables at the school? Would you like some volunteer help from the board committee?
Yes.
Are you going to help me? Sure.
I'm a lunatic on Saturday. So.
Are we going to sell anything or coffee or tea? Or?
Yeah, we're going to do coffee and donuts like we did last time.
Okay.
And then if we run into, start running into the Newtown Owl, we can do pizza too, right? Mm-hmm. Let's do that.
Okay.
Use some water.
Okay.
Yeah, I have a case of water in my basement. I'll bring over with the shirts. And there were two cases left at the school, too.
Are they still there?
In the teacher's room, from what I understand. And I made like $30 selling them at Family Fun Day.
Okay.
Selling them $1.
All right, sounds good. So, Kathy, I'll be in contact with you.
Okay.
And just get everything figured out. I think I sent a bunch of signs and things like that from last year. I wonder if I have like a t-shirt display.
Mannequins? Stuffed animal.
Ooh, great idea.
I have a huge teddy bear.
That's a great idea.
That's actually a great idea.
So while Dan's doing that, so we know the registrations, we cannot do it online, payment-wise. But do we all agree that maybe still having the ability to do it online, the registration itself, but send in money?
I'll have to check with the select board. I like the idea.
Okay.
But I'll check with the select board.
Right, so we can probably find ways of doing it cheap or free.
Okay. Yeah, probably stay up to mom because we have a busy night, but we don't meet again for a couple of weeks.
So you.
If I have time to squeeze it in, I will, but if not, it'll be on the 29th agenda. Negative.
So
this is what Dan's to provide fun, engaging and rewarding recreational activities and experiences for residents of Rollinsford and surrounding communities.
Perfect.
Sold.
Sounds
good.
Okay.
So moved. Anybody want to read it just to get a visual?
It's your original idea.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah, I want
to
picture of it too.
I just edited
it.
Okay. So.
Sounds good, Dan.
Jody made a motion to accept it as read. I'll second the motion.
Are we all in favor?
Aye.
Mission
aye.
Statement?
Aye.
Aye.
Any no's? It sounds good.
Just want to go back. Are you going to contact C&J again?
I don't know. Does Celia want
I
that? Have you, you've been in recent contact or?
In the last 2 weeks.
Okay. Do you want to take that then?
Sure.
Since you've been in I haven't contacted her since I sent her pictures of my children with their t-shirts on.
all right, so you're just going to do it soon?
And I have more pictures I'm sending to her, and I asked her because of our issue with Facebook last year to please refrain from social media postings. It's a third party posting pictures of our camp kids.
No, the ones that are in the pictures are allowed to be taking pictures up.
Okay.
We took those pictures to distribute. There's nothing we can't stop people from stopping on the side of the road and taking pictures of the children. That's the sad part. If we take pictures of people that we know that we can take pictures of and post them, then that's okay.
Yeah.
Because they gave our approval that will be used for social media settings. So, but we can't stop anybody from stopping along the side of the road taking pictures.
Yeah.
When they're at the lake, when they're at the camp, when they're at anywhere.
Yeah.
So.
Okay.
Because I'm sure they want to use those.
Right.
Okay, that's why originally I sent the picture of my kids like right away because I'm like, yeah, you want to put this anywhere, you know?
Right.
Because I was like, I wanted to give them something with their shirts on. So,
and I think the handful of pictures I have with their shirts on are from before, but I asked the directors to confirm that nobody in them
right.
was on the no picture list.
Right.
I never got a response, so
right.
It's a little weird. Are they all supposed to be?
Yeah, I believe there was two. And she only took pictures of people that were allowed.
Okay.
So.
Sally, are your donation letters on Google Docs? Is there an updated version or is it the same one?
It's the same one from last year.
Okay.
Because we haven't set the price, I didn't haven't updated them yet.
Okay.
I just wanted to tell you guys what landed on my lap with basketball. And I think, and this is where, you know, when Suzanne talked about a recreation director, you know, for our town, I discovered why a recreation director is important with just one team of basketball. It takes more correspondence. I can't even tell you how much time I put into basketball for one third, fourth grade team. So like I had to get contacts for, I don't know if they were coaches or ADs or who they were for all the schools around. I had to send them emails. Then I had to wait for them to come back. Are you interested in having a game with us? What dates would you do it? Correspond back and forth with them, find a date that works. Then once they had dates that would work for them and I thought us, then I would have to verify that with Kate Lucas at the school. Can we have basketball games on these dates? I'd have to wait for her to get back to me on that. Once I had settled dates that were okay, then I had to find a rep. And then I had to email a rep to say, are you available on these dates? And then once I had the rep, now I'm still not done with the job, right? So, oh. Speaking of, I need to fill out, we have our first home game on Tuesday night that I need to have a check. I haven't filled out paperwork for it. And I know I asked Caroline when I needed to do that to have you guys sign it by. So
So we only have like, I don't know, maybe four home games. But, you know, I'm also coaching the team and doing this. And it's too much for me. And that's only one program, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's like if we had four teams going. So I really think about, you know, Kelly Young did this before it was a rec thing, and it, I mean, I just think about, wow, how much, it's pretty impressive what she did to organize games and refs, and then they did a concession stand. I'm like, I can't even think about a concession stand. I'm like, I gotta worry about setting up the time, you know, score clock, and setting up chairs. It's terrible. You know, to me, I don't know if it's worth it. I don't, honestly, if, so much easier for me to write a check to Marshwood and say, I'm going to drop off my kids. So I don't know how, you know, as a committee, if.
Could I help by doing concessions or something with that?
That's not the hard part.
Yeah.
The hard part is the coordination.
Yes.
What most teams usually do in other sports is they all meet at the beginning of the season and plan out. The principal would have given you times already,
right,
of when you can use the gym, and then the coaches pick their practice times, and then game days are set aside, and then everybody picks their game days together. At least that's how it's done in baseball and softball.
You know what? I don't know, Jody, if it's done that way. If it is, I have no idea. I could, you know. So I get most of my information from Kristen in Summersworth. Like, she's such a great resource for me.
Right.
So I could ask her how they go about that.
What's going on at the school on most weekends in the gym?
I mean, I know they have play practice right after school.
Right.
Right now.
Five,
right.
Well, the girls team is playing at Summersworth.
Right.
And unfortunately, because they were so late in the game, the 3-4s.
Well, there is a girls team.
But we play with Summersworth because Summersworth couldn't put a team together either.
Oh, I see.
So we're playing at Summersworth, but their practices are so late because they were the last ones to pick. We practice at 7:30 to 9 for third and fourth graders.
Oh, that's really late.
So I said, well, why don't, since half the girls are Summersworth and half the girls are Rollinsburg, let's ask Kate. So Kaylee asked Kate, and Kate said the gym's taken. So she offered her one day. And I'm like, who's using the gym?
Yeah.
So right. I don't know who's using the gym.
Because we only have it two nights a week. We have it Tuesday and Friday, so I don't know who's in the gym. So yeah. So, and I think that's interesting because,
and the play goes to 5, right?
Yeah,
sure,
yeah.
Because the kids were in that. So, and you guys only have two nights a week for
mm-hmm.
game or practice, right?
Yes. I've been trying to schedule our games on either that Tuesday or Friday night as well.
So what's going on Monday, Wednesday, Thursday?
I mean, I don't know. I hate that thing over there, but I just feel like there's not a huge support, you know?
Yeah,
I mean,
I know.
So
do they have to pay somebody to walk up or something?
Oh, that was the other thing. Did I tell you guys that? So I asked her about having a game on a weekend. And I don't know if I said Sunday. I think I asked about Sunday, so I don't know about, I guess I can't say if Saturday was included in that. And I was told that if we wanted to have a game on a Sunday, I would either need to have a volunteer staff member who was there in the building, or we would have to pay them $37 an hour to be there.
For the
I want that gig.
Summersworth does that too.
Otherwise,
there's
like if we wanted to
that
sign up,
I fill out for my kids' birthday parties. It costs me $60 for as long as I want, and they find the staff for me.
Yeah,
but
your $60 is paying for that.
Right. That's paying $37. Yeah. So, and we're trying to avoid paying anything for. So then that was the other thing. So when I thought I was going to schedule Sunday, then I was sending another email to some staff members that I know, like, hey, would you be, you know, positive about, and then the none of my son, none of those games came through anyway, so I just dropped it. But so yeah, it's a lot. It's been very time consuming. Then you know if you have multiple, like when we had four teams, it's like we would have back to back games, back to back practices.
Right.
Like so, yeah, it's a huge coordination scheduling, and I don't have time to do that. So, yeah, I don't know. That's when I look at the rec director. You know, I'm like, oh, it'd be so nice to have. But, you know, when Kaylee volunteered to be a coach, that's fantastic. All she has to do is show up as coach, you know, because Kristen takes care of all the scheduling of the games and the refs, and like that's her job. So, yeah. So just thought I'd tell you guys to share with that it's a tough gig.
How long does the season go?
We had practices in December, and we did open gyms in November. So we tried to get kids, you know, interested. And then December we started practices. We only had our first game on January 14th, so that was our first game. So we've had two games, and Tuesday is our first home game. My son, did you ever see my Facebook post?
No.
Chad's first basket of his life was for the other team. Halftime problems. Switch baskets at halftime. He was flying down the alley. Yeah, it was a great layup. I was screaming, Chad, no. But he still hasn't scored another basket. So I'm like, oh my God. He's like,
2 points
for the LG. But yeah, it was pretty funny.
Okay, I was running the clock. Zoe was playing Zach's team because Zoe's on two teams. So I kept forgetting who was home. And I'm running the clock, and I kept pushing the wrong button, and I made the score even. Parents were screaming from across.
So do you have to have somebody there to keep score too?
Yeah, and I've been reached out to my nephew to try. I'm like, are you available Tuesday to keep score? And he's like, well, no, I have to work for...
The parents will do it.
What time of the game is that?
It's, well, this one's at 6:30. So 6:30 on Tuesday night.
Did you get the money from the parents? Their $20.
I brought it to Caroline on Friday.
Awesome.
So, although I had one check that somewhere the registration form disappeared. So she's like, I don't want the form. I don't want the check without the form. I'm like, so I might have to fill another form for somebody. So we have three Tuesday night games coming up. So we have actually the 23rd is at home, the 30th is away at TCCA.
Mm-hmm.
We're playing you guys. That's at 5:30. That'll be comical.
Yes.
Ours is a co-ed too.
Oh, okay.
And
I'm sure it'll make a basket that.
And we have a two Friday night games, February 9th and 16th. Oh, and we have a home game on the 13th, which is a Tuesday night, at 6:30.
So the
16th
and the 9th are away games?
The 9th and the 16th are home games. Yes. 9, 13, 16 are all home games. Yeah, so if anybody wants to show up and run the clock, that's fabulous. Tuesday night. Kath, you want to run the clock on Tuesday?
I don't have a clue of how to do it.
No, I don't think it really matters. No.
At 3 and 4,
also
that's
chairs.
Fine.
Chairs.
The parents are more happy when you don't pop the clock.
So are the coaches. Yeah. Well, all the lights are there, half the light bulbs are out, so you're like, come, what's the score? I don't know. Yeah, half the light bulbs are, or the one at, even at Idlehurst is on the same side as the bench, so it's really good for the parents, they can see, but the coaches are all like, what's the, how much time is left, and,
Tuesday nights are hard.
Good.
I know. That was a big hit. Pickles. Big pickles. Old. Fuck a pickle.
It's such an odd.
I know, but it was a seller. It was weird. So yeah, so that's kind of my, you know.
Thank you for doing all that.
Yeah.
There are 7 kids on the team with 1 kind of part-time sub. They're like, okay, we might have not enough people, so can you show up? So.
Is it co-ed or just all boys?
No, just all boys. Yeah, we had 2 girls. Was it only 2 that ended up going there?
And 3 with my daughter.
Okay.
That's why she ends up playing for both. She plays for both TCCA and she plays for Summer Shore.
Oh, okay.
So. I told him, like, if it works out with the schedule, we'll make it. If not, then
who's your primary? Who are you choosing over the other?
It doesn't, I let her choose. Okay. She actually had to play her own team the other day, and I let her choose what uniform she wanted to wear.
Oh, that's fine.
I'm letting her pick.
Yeah.
Okay.
But
it hasn't interfered too much, so, because they practice right after school, but they're night, she has 2 practices.
Yeah.
And then I let her decide if she wants to go or not, because she's been so tired.
Yeah.
But I figured it couldn't hurt.
Right.
Oh, good.
So how many girls do they have on that 3rd, 4th grade team?
8. So they have 3 from Rollinsburg and 5 from
Summersburg.
And someone's always out doing something.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. That's why it's kind of risky when you have 7 or 8 kids because
they're
sick.
So they're getting plenty of playing time.
Yeah,
sure.
Which is awesome. Yeah.
So.
They run.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They're tired.
Ten's ideal, really. But
another subject you said you wanted to talk about was it camp or salary limit? Is that what it
was? Well, I wanted to talk about personnel, but
I can
tell you this. So Jody asked me to go ahead and make a schedule for the teen camp, and I guess if we all look at this and kind of think it looks good, I don't know, I didn't reach out to programs yet to say, okay, we're going to come on this day, because, so I didn't know what came first, the chicken or the egg there, but.
I think you should call them now, I don't think they're really calling.
Right.
Yeah.
Can I ask a question?
Sure.
So is this, some of these places like, no, these are different than what the other, the day camp is offering, right? So it would be 2 different transportation systems. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I was just taking a quick look. I wasn't sure if there's any redundancies on there. Would they take the same bus? Would they not take the same bus?
Only on Fridays that we're going to take this together.
Would it be possible to let too much, you know, too annoying to manage, but could you sign up just for like 1 day if a kid's like, I really want to go hiking, but I have no interest in any of this other stuff?
I don't know. That goes to the week when.
You just have to sign up for a week.
That's what, now we're back to, are we signing up for just weeks, which we have to discuss tonight. So, because that's what we were talking about. Like, yeah, we're probably, some kids are going to want to go to this park, but not this, and they're only here this week and that week. But, yeah.
So, we had talked about, I know the take flight thing, which was the expensive thing that we thought everybody, but what I did today when I looked through the calendar, so July 4th actually falls on a Wednesday. So if we run this camp Monday, Wednesday, Friday, what I did, so I had thought about, okay, either we can, you know, make the cost less that week, or, because we talked about just having like a $20 to $30 cost with a kind of a freebie, and that way having the cost is certain, as low really as we can be. But if we are going to go on Wednesday, then I put in a full day at Take Flight, which was the $65 expense, but without the bus and without anything going on that Wednesday, it would still be the...
Neutralize the cost.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Now what is Take Flight?
So Take Flight is the ropes climbing course
okay.
in Kittery. Kittery York, I don't know what's right on that border. And when I called them, they said that we could do a half day, which would be the ropes course.
course, or we could do a half day, or we could do a full day, which was ropes course and zip lining. And so, I mean, it's pretty, but it was expensive. So it's, you know, $65 per person.
So what, right now, if it was a weekly, how old would you charge?
So it's like, what we came up with was 110.
So we did a workshop last time because we didn't have enough people for a meeting. And we looked at 15 campers versus 20 campers and the breakdown of price. And the average for 15 campers was $136 a week. And 20 campers was $110 a week. With 3 weeks being at 120, was less expensive weeks, and $100 for 20 campers. And so we decided that to go with the average of $120 per week.
Thought it was 110.
So did that. For 20 campers.
Yes, 110.
110 for 20 campers.
Mm-hmm.
And that would be with an average weekly cost of $30 for your activity, your special activity. And so.
What do you mean by that?
So on this, so if you guys look, so for instance, like on this Glitz Air Park is a $20 extra charge, but hiking Mount Major is essentially free. All we have to do is pay for the bus.
So you pay $110, but you got to come up with $20 to go to Glitz Air Park?
No.
No,
that's included.
Oh, okay.
So that's kind of why we wanted to keep it between $20 and $30 for each activity.
Oh, okay.
So that's why with the tape.
But it would
like,
be a flat rate. Of
flat rate.
Every week.
Right. And how I came that was I kind of looked at bus cost.
Mm-hmm.
Divided by 20 per week, staff, the cost to, of our staff per person, and then the pool per person.
Try to keep this to, what was it, 30 at most?
For the just the activities, but 110.
I mean, no, I'm sorry, I'm not talking money now, I'm talking about
numbers.
Campers.
So
we're looking at 20 kids right 20 now.
Maximum.
Because then if you go higher than that, you have to hire more staff.
So
right now it's only
two
staff. Yeah, we want to keep it to two staff. But I don't know. I mean, we certainly want to see.
You the first year to start it. Just
and see what comes in.
Right.
You know, I mean, the hard part is, as opposed to what we did last summer, is, you know, we pretty much had everybody pay for the entire summer. But like with this, so we can have people sign up early. But, like, I might only sign up for week 1, 3, and 7, you know, so, yeah, so then it's, like, you know, then you kind of, like, so essentially you need more than 20 kids to
right.
buy
right.
it, right, so that
but
you fill
you
all
have,
the slots.
Right, you can have over 20. Yeah.
But I think if 1 week we have more, then I think we're hoping that we can kind of, you come in and say, okay, I'll take the day off and go meet Deborah.
Right.
Or we can
pull somebody,
a counselor from our other camp if our other camp.
But I mean, it's the overall thing. The budget isn't too high. I mean, you know, it's kind of an experimental run. It's not too much of a risk, you know, money wise.
Yep.
And we were thinking of $30. Suggested last time $30 flat rate fee registration for the summer, right?
Mm-hmm.
For the team camp. So $30 plus how many other weeks you sign up for.
So what if summer camp ends up being different in terms of registration?
Registration fee is different for the families. We recommended the registration fee go up to $40 per family or $25 per child was what we discussed. I should say we discussed that. But we decided $40 per family, and that would include t-shirts.
Yeah, because I wanted to revisit that.
Right.
Like, can't get into my computer again.
So, team program registration fee $30. Camp Raleigh registration fee $40. And they both include shirts.
Do you need the password for the chat?
No.
My computer.
$900
I can't get into it. It's broken.
So 7 weeks. So
oh, it's only 7 weeks.
Yeah.
So, okay.
So 7 times 110 is what?
So
just
are
thinking,
we?
Is that, I mean, just try to just point it down with that. I mean, I guess that worth that. You know, I mean, just thinking.
It would be 770.
Is it worth $770?
It's 7 weeks. Are we doing summer camp still 8 weeks as opposed to summer camp 7 weeks?
Right.
Okay, maybe it is. I don't know.
I don't think any.
I think the college kids,
any age out in.
Okay.
Is going to sign up for a full 7 weeks.
Just
want
to be sure.
Is my thoughts. Because people go on vacation.
Yeah. This week will be late.
Yeah.
And we, last time, well, it was just a workshop, looked at camps from the surrounding area. We looked at Summersworth Camp, and we looked at...
It's expensive.
The teen camp in Summersworth, we looked at...
But is that 5 days a week, though?
I don't know. And then there was one in Mass. Audubon had one that was 3 to 5 days a week. They were charging $300 to $500 per week for 9 to 5, 3 to 5 days a week. And one of them was like kayaking for a week and hiking for a week. And then there was one at UNH, which is 2 weeks. And 1 week's like $150 or $175, and you're on campus. And then the following week, your field trip's all week. And that week is $350. But you're going to like the Museum of Science in Boston or to the planetarium or something like that. So you're on the go. So we are priced lower than some of the other, a lot lower than some of the other programs, and to go for the whole summer, even though it'd be $700. That's a lot less than what people are paying in the surrounding communities.
But this is 3 days a week. And so I think these places are great, but they're not as big of a draw as some of the other stuff you're talking about. Like, I mean, I'm nothing against these places. I think it would be fun, you know, but I was just thinking, or is somebody going to look at this and say, really? I mean, I really want to spend that much money for this, you know?
Yeah, no, I get that. I just think, too, that we also have to consider our audience. We're in a community where it's like, you know, we have to try to offer something affordable, you know what I mean?
No, yeah, no, I'm saying there's any way we can make it cheaper.
Yeah,
I'm thinking that more than the other way.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah. No, I'm from a parent's perspective, like, you know, is this worth, is doing this stuff worth that money?
The big expense, and I think that's my thought on fundraising, is the big expense of this camp is transportation. Because they want to be bused to places out of the week. I mean, this is kind of a third, but it's not really going anywhere. But, you know, that's a big part of what they have to pay for.
And are you guys charging, I should be looking at the stuff you guys bring me, but are you charging separately for the bus transportation, or is it going to be, is it baked in?
Everything's included.
Okay, sorry.
So there are three things baked into your price that are constant. The staff, the buses, and the pool fees are baked into the $110 per week.
And the activities.
And your activities.
So there's no extra charge.
Okay. So it's all baked
like
in
for
there.
Anything.
And so if you're looking at the week-to-week cost for us, the constants that are going to remain the same week after week are the buses, the staff, and who's the pool fees.
Yeah.
And then on a week-to-week basis, if we're looking at expenditures, what's going to go up are the what's going to change is the activity fees.
Right.
That's the variable.
So just with, so if we have 20 kids, if you just look at, so with the bus and paying our payroll comes to $70 per kid.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there's really nothing we can do about that.
Yeah,
you know?
No, I hear you.
And there's no,
I just don't
bus. There's a 15-person
yeah,
bus.
That's
right,
that's the problem,
put
too.
Put all this together and then have people say, oh, this is too expensive, or why this isn't worth it. And,
yeah.
You know, I don't know.
Yeah, how
maybe not. Yeah, maybe people...
I mean, my whole thing about that, I mean, doing this is like, and I said it even to the budget committee, you know, I said, this population doesn't need money spent on them, right? They don't need a babysitter. They can stay at home and not, you know, my feeling is I don't want my kids sitting at home
right.
all
yeah,
summer
right.
long because this is all they're going to be doing,
right.
like all day.
I love the idea. just thinking, I guess. Just
right. I mean, if we could make it, I know, I was trying to look at less than $100, but I just don't think we can do it.
With the bus and everything, yeah.
Yeah.
And we started with like this master plan,
kayaking, yeah,
waterboarding.
That's what you do.
No, I think that stuff's great.
Yeah.
I even reached out to Feliciano for an air conditioned bus. That's
right, right, yeah.
Smack down on that one.
Yeah.
Do
hey,
you want to look at that? Because I know a lot of those reaper
like
ideas.
Realistically, my daughter will be 12, and we might do, and she has a friend who might be interested in this, and might do 2 weeks of it, you know, maybe
mm-hmm.
three, you know, so.
And I mean, honestly, that's my feeling with my kids, too. Right.
There's no way.
Yeah.
Yeah, I look at that and think, oh, James will do maybe one thing this week and maybe one thing next week, but he will not go all week. It's just, But I'd have to pay for the full week.
But you have to pay. That's why I asked, because I'm looking at some of this.
I think it's just too complicated for us to choose one activity per week that
Dan, you asked, it's $770 for the summer plus the registration fee, so it would be a flat $800.
If
you did the whole summer,
yeah.
That's how much it would be.
You know, you might get some people who just want to get their kid off the cup so bad that they're willing to pay that.
Yeah, because James is right at that age that he doesn't want to be considered a camper.
Yeah.
But I don't want him home.
Right.
So what's the compromise?
Is he 12 now?
Yeah, he's 12 now. He'll be 13 in September.
Okay.
So at the last meeting,
the AP qualifies for
seventh grade?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But that's actually another question. Is it 13 to...
We had that, so we had this discussion that last time that we talked about 12 being the age, but also having 12 the age of Camp Raleigh kids.
So
and the discussion being that parents can sign up their 12-year-old at either camp, whatever they felt was comfortable for their child.
Okay.
Like some people, you know, wouldn't want their kids to be in the teen camp
or child care at 12.
Right, right. Or they want their kids watched all day, every day.
Yeah.
And this is what,
right? Isn't that what happened?
It's a tough age. I mean, I wouldn't be comfortable just keeping, I mean, our situation is totally different than most people because we're around a lot of the stuff.
Right.
You know, it's totally different, but I wouldn't feel comfortable or just staying a little longer.
Yeah.
Like I would feel comfortable sending him over to this at 12 and not that.
Right, and I feel like that with, like, Shelby could have done that last year, but, like, my twin would probably going to say no way.
I had a conversation
with that to the council.
But it's nice to give the option, you know, parents know their kid and which one.
Right, which one is the better. Yes.
Two questions. What time do you think they're going to be back?
I think, do we have the 4 o'clock? Time or I mean I to me I don't even know but
what time does the they get back from the pool?
3?
Is it around 3?
3:30.
Oh,
right,
right.
Like 3:30.
I was thinking of somebody that would might want to be interested in that job if we can get her home by 3:30.
Oh yeah.
My niece.
Mm.
I've been hitting her up so.
Mm.
So she has to be there somewhere by 3:30 or
I don't know. I'm assuming with him. I have no idea.
Oh, well, she said to work at the hospital for early.
Oh, that's why. Okay.
Yeah.
I don't know. She knows better than me. So that was. So, yeah.
Did we talk about age of counselors?
Did you guys want to look at that?
What was it last year? 16 plus, right?
So I'm going to go.
But we had a couple 15
year olds. We had a ratio.
We never had 15 year olds. We stuck
everyone
with 16. Yes.
Okay.
But we had a ratio.
Yeah, it was 51%.
Okay.
Had to be over 18.
18, right. But there was no 15, it was 16. Okay, so
16, 17.
Students of other.
No, we changed that ratio in June to 49%.
look at it for a minute.
Oh, that's right, because we couldn't find the one person, so we had to ask the select board to make that change at the last minute.
So 49% 16?
Yes.
Okay.
But for the teen camp program one, obviously we're going to fund some older kids or young adults.
Yeah.
Yes.
So at our last meeting, we said an inquiry was made about the teen camp and if they could attend Camp Raleigh on their days off. It was strongly against that because the days off are going to be field trip days for Camp Raleigh. So you can't sign your kids up. You have to choose between Camp Raleigh or the teen camp. You can't
jump the lines.
Right.
You can't breach the lines of.
So even so, if you're talking about your 12-year-olds, right?
Yeah.
We want your 12-year-olds to either be
sure.
One camp or the other.
They have to pick.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
And so we had talked to about having a fee that for them to come to Camp Raleigh on the days off, but that doesn't work with it being a field trip day. And so you have to choose. And it was suggested or requested. We set a date before the registration forms go out. Your child must be 12 by April 15th or June 1st. So we're not getting these kids that are 11 and a half. They'll be, or 11 and 3/4. 3 weeks into camp, they'll be 12. Can they attend? We want that black and white line.
Didn't we say January 1st?
I thought it was something like that.
I thought it was January 1st.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Sounds good.
Yeah, they have to be 12 by January 1st, 2018. Do we need to move the date? Do we need to move February or something?
So by what 12? So what were you asking about 12? I don't know.
So what date is the cutoff date? You have to be 12.
Have to be 12.
First day.
You don't
camp.
Have to be eligible.
Yeah,
I love that.
Yeah, why not?
First day of camp.
Right. Why
you need to go back to
it. Yeah, I think the more you go towards the first day of camp, the better.
Yeah.
Because I was like, okay, if I hit January 1st, then I'm sure they're going to be 12 and a half.
So why don't the first week of camp is June 25th? I want to do June 1st.
June 25th is the first day of camp?
Yes.
Well, what we want to open that team came up with as many kids as possible.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Because it's our new
venture. I'll go to June 1st.
Is that something we vote on?
Yes. We can, and
yeah.
Maybe if we do have folks that come to us and say, okay, so May 30th is my child's birthday, we make an exception. Maybe we just do it case by case.
Mm-hmm.
We say June 1st, but maybe case by case. I mean,
no, but May 30th. May is still okay.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
But I get your point.
Yeah.
It was
the other way.
So I make a motion to have a firm cutoff day of June 1st to be 12 to attend Camp Raleigh Teen Camp. June 1st, 2018. Thank you. I need a second.
All those in favor?
Any opposed? None.
Let's talk about your.
Maybe one more thing on team?
Yeah.
The fees. So, are we going to make it per week?
Absolutely.
Okay.
I think
we
should absolutely do it per week.
Okay. And if they. What?
I think we need to. I'd like to visit the out of town fee because I think we might be pricing some people out. I think. What did we come up with on that one?
Was that what we said? I like that number. I thought it was higher.
140.
Yeah, see. I think we should go 125. I think that's more reasonable. Or I don't know. If we're trying to get as many people as we can, maybe we want to go less. 120, I don't know.
was a, there was
I didn't write down, we had a town press.
Okay. I think are we, how, we, didn't we talk how we do it with Camp Raleigh is it's $100 more for the entire summer, right? So I think that was my thought, that if we, because we're charging out of town people $100 more for Camp Raleigh,
mm-hmm.
so if we take 100 and divide it by 7 weeks for the teen camp, it comes to $14.28. So in that respect, if we go 125 for out-of-towners, it's like equal, equal money that we're charging them for being out of town as we are the Camp Raleigh kids. Does that make sense to you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I'll second that.
Just to let you know. Was there a motion? I guess I didn't really.
You just
did. I made a motion. I didn't say I made a motion, but I guess I made a motion.
I did. Before we go on, can I add that $30 registration fee?
Mm-hmm.
So, was that
second? Are we? Does everybody know what's on the plate there?
I can repeat it. So, fees for teen camp are $110 for in-town residents per week, $125 out-of-town residents per week, plus a registration fee of $30.
Is that per person, or is it per family?
Per family.
Per family. $30 registration fee.
Okay. Okay, so are we all in favor of our new pricing for teen camp?
Aye.
Any opposed? Good.
Can I make one more motion?
Sure. Get some business done today.
If someone wants to pay for the, right now it's over $700 if you go all 7 weeks.
It's $800 for the registration.
Right. So, should we have a discount? But what if $600 if you pay for the whole summer?
You want to go that cheap? I'd go $700.
And do you want to do it differently for out of town residents versus in town residents?
Absolutely. I think
we're
not.
It just makes the whole idea.
I haven't looked at like what.
You know what?
Makes up the 100. Well, I know what makes up the 100. But
what I was thinking.
So we don't want to take a
hit.
We don't want to get spent on it either.
Right.
So
was it 120?
I mean, I see what she's saying about the
yeah,
discount.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
actually a good idea. It's just how much.
I mean, just $40 off. You know what I mean? Not too much.
But you said it was $70 per week just for. I was going back in my notes. For the staff and the buses, right? And then
the pool. So that would be. So that's 75 for the breaks down to that 45, 75 just for.
And then you've got the activity.
Back in the activity, right.
So you don't. There's not much room to be able to. So an offer, but then you could do something, right? I mean, maybe we could think of something. 10%.
10% would bring you down to.
And what about multiple kids? Do we want to do that too? Or just leave everything kind of flat?
I would leave it flat.
Yeah, I can think particularly of a friends of ours in town who have a ninth grader and then twin seventh graders. So potentially that's they have three in this age group now. So I don't know.
So multi-kid discount.
Mm-hmm.
I like the idea more of if you pay for the
right.
for everything up front, you get a discount. I like that better.
Right.
We could do.
Yeah, I agree. I think I would lean that, you know, unfortunately. We just, maybe in the
maybe
next years or years in
right,
the future, we
could
do that this summer, no? Yeah.
There's not much wiggle room when you look at the expenses for the admission fee.
Yeah. Yeah, we're right at that.
Mm-hmm.
It might be, what, $5 maybe?
That was summer camp, and we want you to figure out everything. You go through all the numbers, you realize we didn't have any wiggle room to offer
right.
free this and free that. We just didn't have it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
The bus, we get less gracious, we get spanked on buses.
And do we know, I meant to give this to, so I got, this was sent to me via the school or something crazy, but First Student sent me a bill. And for that, remember that last busing thing? But I thought Carolyn took care of that, so I don't know.
Well, you know about a desk, right? Just
yeah.
Out.
Remember she reached out to us and said, is this a legit receipt or that I, so I don't know if it was paid or not. But they found me. I don't know how they found me.
So, do you want to go back to the full summer discount? We started on that.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, do you have a wiggle room to offer 10% off? So, if somebody
maybe
wants to do a full.
Maybe a chance to look at the numbers more.
Yeah, maybe a little
bit. Well, the two of the cheaper ones is Blitz and Hilltop Fun Center. And I did put, I thought I was going to do Hilltop Fun Center twice, and I showed it to one of my kids, and she's like, we're not going to Indoor Scent. So, you know, then I threw the Indoor Scent in there. But, I don't know, we could maybe $50 off? Do we want to do that?
For what?
For the whole summer.
So that would give you bring it down from 800 to 750.
Sure. Is your name? I thought it was my name.
No, my name's
or
not ordered by from 770 to 720, but then you still have to pay the $30 registration.
So that must have been.
Yeah, they sent it to the school and then they sent it to me.
Yeah.
So,
okay. Just do you have this different one?
Yeah.
Yeah. If you really want the Carolina, I'll do it.
770.
Yeah.
For the summer.
Plus the $30.
And if you took away $50, that would bring me down to $720.
Okay. So it makes it $750 for the whole stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. How's that going to be
done? I totally missed it. I'm just looking at the bill.
Okay. Motion?
$50 off, basically.
$50 off.
Motion?
For how many weeks you're
paying? A whole summer discount.
Whole summer discount. If you're coming all 7 weeks.
Oh, you have to come all 7 weeks to get a $50 discount.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Anybody who's paying in full for all 7 weeks.
Okay.
In San Diego or out of town.
All
right. Or out of town, or is it if they, so that one, what did I just put, 875, I think it was, 125 times 7 is 875. So it would be 8. That's not including the registration fee. So it would be $825 for the whole summer plus the registration.
So
$855.
So I'll make a motion for a whole summer discount all 7 weeks paid up front in full. Gets a $50 off both in town and out of town residents.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? No.
So family discount. Were you gonna do that multiple kids?
I think we all said no for the first summer. That a possibility for following
Summers is up there.
Yeah.
Is everybody okay with that?
Yes.
I am.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes.
Just putting this together on a piece of paper is going to be a logistical nightmare.
Especially on a piece of registration packet.
I know.
Crazy.
This was my high tech scheduling.
Hey, it looks good to me.
I'll put it in Excel if I have a cancellation tomorrow. And I'm going to reach out to the guy at Indoor Ascent, because if we have some rain dates in there, I'm going to ask him if we can, because we do have the movie option, which is fine, because if it's a rain, that should be okay with our money to go to a movie, or we could hopefully possibly go to Indoor Ascent if it's a rainy day. So it seemed like a con and stuff.
You want to talk staffing?
Yeah, you want to do that?
Could you possibly take a picture of that and send it to me, or when it gets into a different format?
Jody did already.
I'll
send it to you in this format, and when I put it in Excel, I'll send it to you too.
Right.
Yeah.
I'll take it.
Okay. Take it to. Okay, so that means if we talk personnel, we have to go into
non-public.
Okay.
Motion move on to non-public for reasons of personnel.
Second, or do I say second or not?
Second.
Second.
All in favor? Roll call. Go. Roll call.
Happy
Miss Emily. Tell you later, bye.
Kelly
Anderson, aye.
Dini Dog, aye.
Julian Boykrings, aye.
Just trying to work out the 5-minute thing, so I'll send
that
all out.
Weird.
So, yeah, we came up with a.
No, but we had a touchdown and they took it away, so I wonder what happened. So it's 38-7. Yeah.
A lot of people in Minnesota are really bummed right now.
Yeah. Eagles, which, and their top quarterback got hurt.
I was
really
worried
about
this one last week. I was like, oh no, we're going to lose.
Yeah, I think we need to. I think we need to do that time.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm tired. So I'll send everything out. But if you could send me some of the details that you got.
I was just looking at the notes from our workshop, and we had put King Camp last time out of town residents at 140. So we dropped it $15.
Which I think is important. I think that we might have out.
So now I can start marketing.
Yes. Good. All right. What
and we decided to go $55 per week.
Okay.
For what?
Okay. Well, if I get a flyer together, can you go to Marshwood SAU and make sure they get handed out? And the Summer Shore SAU and make sure they get handed out?
That's fine. Where'd you write down?
All right.
Motion to adjourn. Can I do that?
Second.